Alrighty, y'all, so I've got this deck that I've had a little while and I almost threw it out because of a little bit of frame damage that it has. I'm glad I didn't because I think I'm gonna use it to repower this, repower it. It's a 22-inch deck, older Murray that has the bicycle wheels on it. Pretty desirable amongst quite a few people, especially those that knew what these things were when they were new. And it has the ball bearing front wheels. These are the ones that get really brittle and crack and fall off, but these are actually in pretty decent shape. No real visible cracks. They're a little bit dry rotted, but as long as the person takes care of it, they shouldn't have any problems with them. And then y'all saw this 3.5 horsepower engine from the late 1970s, or at least that's what the engine cover is saying. It's got the white paint on it, so it's pretty vintage, so to speak. Where it says, looks like 1978, roughly in May of 1978 is roughly when that engine was made. This deck was probably made sometime in the late 80s or early 90s. And I'll show you where this has a little bit of frame damage, and the engine that was on it was bouncing up and down like crazy because of this crack. It's kind of cracked it pretty good right in this general area. But the advantage to this engine is that it'll mount on the mower backwards, which means I could use this mounting bolt instead of this one for the backwards mount, and it should work like it's supposed to. I think it's far enough away from where the frame is damaged to really affect this portion of the frame. But if I get it on there and it's still vibrating like crazy, might put it on one of my newer deck frames, just to give it a good mower deck to go on. I think this one will work for what it is. And so all I should have to do, I did notice that this one's got a little a n newer style gas tank and carburetor on it. I have done one or two of these older engines with the new style gas tanks and carburetors, and they seem to be okay. I'm gonna put this one on here and see what it does. I think we'll be all right with it. This is going to be kind of a little experiment with this deck and this engine. So all I got to do is first off start it and or mount it onto this deck, and so that's what I'll do first. Again, I'm just gonna I'm probably just go ahead and do it. Just gonna put it on here backwards, or reverse orientation of what you usually do, the modern push mower, and so. And it lines up with those bolt holes that I pointed out. So it should be all right. Let me mount it and get a blade on it. I know this engine will run. I'll mount it, get a blade on it, and see what this thing might be able to do. All righty, so I got everything back together. I'm going to have to figure out how to make this thing a little safer to turn off, which will be my next little project. That is, if it runs. I've already put a blade on it. Nice blade on it. Got it sharpened. Put new oil in it. I've got gas in it. And I've got the air filter cover and stuff for it, but for right now, I'm just going to try and see if it runs. And if it does, we'll keep going further. Priming great. Alright, let me set this down.
Thank you.
got a little smoke to burn off, but it's not really vibrating that much. It's got a little bit of smoke to burn off, like I said. But I think this one might be a good runner here. I'll tackle trying to figure out how to more safely turn this thing off next. I don't know if I'll install a ground wire a little bit further up the handle or what, but because I'm just not sure, but we'll dive into that next. So I started out and I actually had it a little bit too full with oil and had to drain some out, but with this type drain plug, there's no real easy way to drain a little bit out without getting it all over the mower. So I've got a kind of a nice oily coat on it now, but I'll clean it off and wash it off some more. Ended up taking the head off just because I figured it'd probably have a lot of oily residue on it. And it looks like this magneto is so old that it doesn't have a place to put a ground wire. So I'm going to improvise a little bit and maybe put a ground wire that attaches to the handle so that they don't have to go all the way to the mower to turn it off. All it was for these older mowers, the 7/16 bolts to take the engine cover off, and it's three of them. One, two, and then three. And then three is on the head over here. Wherever I put the head, right here. The third one will mount there. And so as you can see, it's pretty caked with oil on the inside. And I know it won't hurt to put one in the cylinder walls. Cylinder walls have a little bit of scoring, but I don't think it's bad enough to not mess with. Like I said, it runs great. It's just been smoking a little bit. And I still might have it a little bit too full with oil, so I'll clean off the residue on this head and put it back on and see what it'll do. So I got the head back on, spark plug on, and as y'all can see, what I decided to do about grounding, it's not really my favorite solution, but for an engine of this vintage, it's about the only option, since I don't have really any distinct ground wire coming to a safety cable or safety switch. I took that little metal piece I had that was on that old Sycamore 19 mower that I had, that I fixed the safety with the two zip ties in the front, and just put that metal piece on there. So all you have to do to turn it off, and like I said, I didn't want to do it this way, but this is about the best way I could do it given the setup, is just pushing this down with your foot and grounding it out. You know, as long as you got rubber-soled shoes on, you're not even gonna know any difference. And it's never a good thing to cut grass with bare feet. So so I think that solution will work. I just got to make sure this thing doesn't smoke. And so I'm going to take it down. I'm going to take it down and start it up and maybe let it run for a few minutes and see if it smokes after I clean the head out. Hopefully so. Hopefully that scoring on the cylinder walls isn't bad enough to where it's just smoking like that all the time. but we'll see. So I ran this thing a little bit, and I just don't like how it runs with this newer style carburetor on it. It acts like it wants to bog down and not get, or it's like it's getting too much gas or something, but then it'll catch after a while. Sometimes it takes a minute, sometimes it takes 10 seconds, but I don't want to sell it like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, since I haven't found an air filter cover for the Sycamore here, I'm going to take the older style carburetor and gas tank from it and put it onto here for the time being. I still got one more older gas tank if I find an air filter cover for that, that I can buy a diaphragm for. So yeah, I'm gonna swap it to the correct carburetor on this mower, and hopefully that'll fix the running problem on it. Although it does run good once it gets going, even with this carburetor. So I'm gonna do that next. So I took the gas tank off to swap it out with the period correct one, and noticed that the intake tube is a little bit loose on it, which probably is contributing to the problem of it not quite running right for a little bit. So I'm going to tighten those little quarter inch screws up here, and hopefully that'll get it tight, and then I'll put the old gas tank on and we'll give her a start. Alright, so I tightened up the intake tube and I put this period correct carburetor on it for the engine. Hopefully those two combined will help this thing run a little bit better so that it doesn't sound like it's choking itself. So let me put this down and give this thing a start and see what it does. smoking just a little bit, but for the engine to be almost 40 years old, that probably is kind of par for the course. It does run great. I like the choke was hung up a little bit there on the start, so I'm going to work on it a little bit more, but I do like the way that this mower runs a lot better than with the other one. So I like I said, I'll keep working on it a little bit more, but I think I'll have a good decent runner here. Get, you know, $40 or $50 out of something that didn't have any money in, so it'd be a good deal. But yeah, just getting this older Murray resurrected and back to life. I'll have another one hopefully coming up before long if I get some more trade-ins, but thank you all for watching.